tribute this thing. This set of parentheses into this set of parentheses, okay? I'm gonna treat this parentheses here as I would any other thing that I'm multiplying by another set of parentheses. Let me just, quick reminder here. I had x, 8x plus 3, and I want to distribute the number 5. How would that look, Randy?
No, it's
40x plus 15, exactly. Or to write it kind of a silly way, 5 times 8x plus 5 times 3. See how that guy there got multiplied by the 8x and by the 3? Yes, Raimi?
Yes.
You see it?
Yeah.
I'm going to keep calling on you until
I don't
need
me
to. Until you don't.
Turn around, Ramsey.
So I'm going to distribute this whole thing just like I did with the 5. We'll have 8x minus 3 times 8x. Distribute it to the 3 here. And we get 8x minus 3 times 3. Dylan, what did I just do?
I don't know how to explain it. I got the answer right.
Jenna, what did I just do? How did I do that? What would you say I did in this step here?
You just divided those two up and then you distributed it into it.
Distributed this into this.
It's an easier, simpler way I've gotten people understand.
Nope.
It's the same thing.
Nope. Just for a second. Just for a second. Now. We have 8x minus 3 times 8x. Raimi? And 8x plus, minus 3 times 3 plus 3x. So what would I do next, Raimi? You still need me to call. Distribute what?
8x to the 8x.
Okay, and that gives us?
64.
Yes.
Squared.
Yes.
Minus 24x plus 64x.
Now where's that 64x coming from?
That's 8 going back to the other 8x.
This one?
Yes.
Let's talk about that. So the reason we distribute is because... Why do I distribute this 5 into the parentheses here? Because of this. 5 is being... It's being multiplied, yeah, 5 times. It's being multiplied. Now, Raimi, is this 8x being multiplied by this parentheses?
No.
It's being added. So we wouldn't distribute something that's not being multiplied. What is being multiplied by this parentheses? The 3.
Oh, yeah.
We distribute it to the 3, we multiply by 3. So we distribute the 3. We get plus 24x minus 9. And there's a plus 3x there at the end.
64x.
What do we see now? 64x
plus 3x.
Squared, maybe? Coming.
Oh, that's not sorry.
Okay.
Plus 3x.
Plus 3x.
Minus 9.
Minus 9. That was pretty easy, right? Because you get a negative 24x plus 24x. And they cancel each other out and you get 0 there. If you happen to notice this pattern, then you can maybe shortcut this. That's always going to happen. The negative 24 and the positive 24 canceled because these two look almost identical to each other, right? These two sets of parentheses, except for what's the only difference between the two?
Negative. And positive.
Positive. The middle sign there, the sign of the second term, is opposite. Those are what you call conjugates. When you multiply conjugates, you always get the middle stuff canceling out.
I know. So, my idea here from the multiplying the two parentheses, when you do that, just think of it as cutting one of those in half.
Cutting
one of the sets in half. Like
okay, cutting this set in half.
Yeah, but one keeps the variable and one keeps the sign. Depending on the order.
Yeah, the variable keeps the sign.
Yeah. That's what I've been doing.
Oh.
Right, well, I'm not going to stop you from telling other people, but from up here, I'm not going to do that. Because it's one of those memory things that we have to remember correctly. But if it works for you, then if it works for others that you might tutor.
Just think of it, because like, if you're going to times 8x minus 3 times that order, if you know you cut them in half, you're just going to take 8x and then times that, and then you're going to do negative 3.
You mean take this 8x and multiply it by, like, distribute it to the 8x plus
3? Yeah, it's just cutting it in half. The big parentheses.
I understand what you're saying.
Okay.
The problem that I have with it is it's not mathematical. It's memorical. Like, we're trying to just memorize a process. Not that it's incorrect, and not that it doesn't give us the right answer, but when I ask you, why does that work, or what's the math behind that, so far you're just telling me cut it in half. It's a process that will work. But what I'm trying to teach is always based in the mathematics.
Yeah.
You know, the distribution is the way that we multiply something by the parentheses. And we can go back and we can confirm the distribution must work every time.
Okay.
We can prove it mathematically.
Yeah.
Right? And so by using distribution, I can mathematically prove like all of this
that
stuff.
Was using the distribution. Same thing you're doing up there. But it's okay, I'm just suggesting something.
I appreciate it. It's just, here, let's do the same problem. And just with one little extra bit there, we'll wind up doing the exact same thing you just said. Wow, that was worth it. Okay, let's distribute this. This. It doesn't really matter which one we distribute to which one. Okay? And we're gonna wind up splitting it in half and distributing this into there and this into there. So we'll just distribute the 8x plus 3. Get 8x times 8x plus 3, distributing that to the 8x. Now distributing it to the negative 3, we get negative 3 times 8x plus 3. Plus 3x. So now we see here exactly what you said. Take the 8x times that, distribute it into the second set of parentheses. And, well, I'm not going to write it again.
64x squared.
Yeah.
Get the exact same thing, of course. It's, it'll be in slightly different order, but it'll be the same.
24x.
Negative 24x, negative 9.
Why do you get negative?
It's from the other parentheses.
Oh. I was doing the first parentheses.
Oh. You want to go to 64x squared plus. Okay.
That's really confusing.
I don't mean to shoot you down. It's just that.
Okay. If it works for you,
if it works for you, use it. But I won't make it the primary tool that I use to teach it to you.
Yeah, I know.
Okay, other questions? Worksheet, yes?
You never told us like how that game worked that we play in like the beginning of school.
Black Magic?
Yeah.
Well, we'll have some time today. I think we could play it again.
Oh, man.
You just like never told us like, why it works, like how you do it.
You gotta be picked.
No, that's not my style.
It's like seeing who's better at wine.
Let's get back to this. Any other questions before we put everything away and take a moment for you?
I'm stoked. Just give me work.
You ready? You ready?
Maybe
you're ready?
Yeah. If you really want to stay, you can plan the second Egyptian pharaoh.
Too much.
That's too much.
All right, move on.
Can we do like one more?
Which one would you like to do?
You want our pharaoh now.
Two?
Two.
I'm going to steal this again.
Everywhere possible. Pick that up. Pick it up.
All
right.
She told me it was gross.
I didn't tell you to
say
that.
What?
Rainy. What is yours, Rainy? Keep on taking it. Go ahead. Tell me how to proceed.
The first parentheses. The
first parentheses.
Second parentheses.
We can distribute it into the second parentheses.
Yeah.
Which would give us what? Oh, well, you're doing it all at once, which is fine. But I'm going to do it in just one extra step.
I'm asking how to do it.
That's plus 5 times x squared. You did it for me last time. Let's say plus x plus 5 times negative 2x plus x plus 5 times 3 plus 2x minus 8. Now we have 3 times, we have to distribute again. We have three terms here, this guy here, this one, and this one, which we need to distribute to simplify. So x squared times x?
X cubed,
yes, for sure. Because what does x squared mean? X times x, and then what are we going to do? Multiply by x. So we get x times x times x. Just three x's. X squared times 5? 5x squared. Now this gets kind of weird because I got a negative over here. So let's make sure to keep track of those signs. Raimi?
She left.
Let's go ahead and distribute this negative 2x into the x plus 5 for me.
2x squared plus
2x. It's going to be negative 2x squared minus 10x.
Yeah.
Just keep going. I can tell you really need me to keep helping you. Go ahead. Let's turn our bodies toward learning. So, distribute there too.
3 goes into the x.
3 goes to the x.
3
times the s. Huh? And then we have 2x. Okay, so let's collect any like terms we see. Might be helpful to say, like, there's an x to the third, and, well, there's no other x to the third, so that's taken care of. Maybe circle the x squareds. There's some, there's two of those, so 3x squared. Maybe underline the x terms. Negative 10x plus 3x is negative 7x. Plus 2x is negative 5x. 15 minus 8.
And that is
7. 7. Mm-hmm. Jenna.
Apparently, I got that, like, I got that right. Like, I have it right there, but, like, on the chess of answers, it said it completely different.
Oh, that could be my mistake. Let's see.
Which first one?
Can you do this? Like the chess.
2x cubed plus 7x. Let's see what I had. What did I have?
3x minus 5x plus 7.
But wait.
Okay, let's make sure that these two should match up here.
Yeah, they're
3x squared. But, oh, do you see what I did?
Yeah.
I must have added the 2x squared and the 5x squared, not subtracted the 2x squared. So. Not 7x squared, but 3x squared.
Oh,
thank you, Jenna.
That right.
Okay.
Yeah.
You ready?
Sure.
Let's go.
Is that the antsiness of the class that's ready to move on?
I'm ready.
Just give me a
shoulder. Let's get started, please. Okay. Now, I could distribute this x plus 2 to the 3x and the negative 5. It would look like this, x plus 2 times 3x. Say that negative minus x plus 2 times 5. Okay, and then I would distribute this 5 into the x plus 2 and this 3x into the x plus 2. But a little bit of a quicker way would be to recognize that that's going to happen every time. That I'm going to distribute this to each of these terms every time. And that, in turn, will result in me distributing this into the x plus 2 and this term into the x 2. So, if you wanted, you could skip that little step there. So if I need to explain, like if you make a mistake there in distributing this way, I'm going to go back to the explanation of distributing the parentheses and then distributing. But all that's going to happen is this 3x is going to get distributed into the x plus 2. So you wind up with 3x squared plus 6x. The negative 5 will get distributed into the x plus 2. So we'll get negative 5x minus 10. 3x squared plus 1x, 6x minus 5x is 1x, minus 10. So there's an option. You could have gone the other way too. You could distribute the x to the 3x and to the negative 5. 2 to the 3x and to the negative 5. And all that would really happen is you'd get negative 5x plus 6x. And that would come out to the exact same thing. Okay. Any questions about that? Okay. Here we have it again, the double distribution part of it. Go ahead and do it that shorter way. Going to have to wind up distributing the 3x into this parentheses, getting 15x squared plus 12x. And I would distribute this negative 1 to both of these terms, getting negative 5x minus 4. And we have all this stuff as well. Here's 15x squared, 2x squared, those are all the x squared, so you get 17x squared.
Yeah, nice.
No.
Did I just come wrong?
No, you're right.
Okay, 12x minus 5x is 7x.
Plus 2x.
Oh, plus 2x is
9.
8x. Good catch. And there's the only thing left is a minus 4. So 17x squared plus 9x minus 4.
Yeah.
Any questions about that one? You guys nailed it?
Yep. Woo, yep. I did, A plus.
And if you didn't, then you understand why you didn't?
Yes.
That's good.
A plus.